thank you, Mayor. Thank you for opening up your doors to us and putting together this great group. It's an honor to be out in Bonner Springs with all of you. This is probably one of the most favorite parts of the job for me, the opportunity to visit with constituents, tell you what we're doing in Washington, tell you what we're trying to stop doing to you in Washington, talk about what you're seeing, and I really want to listen. I'm here to answer questions. I'm going to give you kind of an overview a little bit about what we've been up to.
National Guard is signing up soldiers with the promise of repaying student loans.
Even in the state level, KDH&E. And there's so many regulations that it's hamstringing.
There is a belief in about half the folks who are in Congress in Washington that regulations create jobs. Okay? And so that's the first step, is they believe that when they regulate a business and say you've got to put on new air filters or something new in your business, and you've got to hire somebody to do that, that they've created a job for them. They forget the fact that you could have spent that money somewhere else. You could have hired a more productive worker. You could have saved the money. You could have expanded your business. You would have spent it somewhere else. And so they believe that when we cut government spending, we're killing jobs. When we cut regulations, we're killing jobs. And this is a fundamental question. Do we believe that money creates better wealth when it's in the hands of the American people and when they have the authority to build and not be burdened by regulations? Or do we think they're better off when we have a centralized, more centralized, powerful government that has more regulation and more federal workers? Sir, I'm with you on this one, but it's a battle we fight every day in Washington. It is a huge, huge question to our security. You know, we are a sovereign nation that cannot guard its own borders. I mean, just think about that. We're the United States of America, the most powerful country in the world, the most prosperous country in the world, and we can't regulate who comes in and out of our country. Isn't that staggering? That we can do all these things. We can provide free health care for every American. We can build, rebuild Iraq. We can rebuild Afghanistan. We can keep people coming in and out of Iraq and Afghanistan. We can now we're in a third conflict over in Libya. Yet at home, people come in and out as much as they want. And so it's a national security question, first of all. And the first thing we ought to do is get serious about our border. We need to use technology. We need to continue to build defense. We need to put National Guard at the border. We need to do everything we can to protect our sovereignty. Because this isn't just an immigration question. It's a sovereign nation question. Then we need to completely overhaul our immigration system. I don't know. No one but a schizophrenic mad scientist would ever dream up an immigration system where we reward bad behavior by saying, if you can make it through our borders, you can get here. We don't want you to get here, but if you can get here, then you're good to go. And that if you can't get here, if you want to come in legally, well, that's going to take 10 years. So we punish the good actors that are trying to come through the system, and we reward the bad actors. And so I'd like to see that reversed. I'd like to see, we need to bring in, continue to bring legal immigrants into this country. That's what built this nation. We're a hard nation of immigrants. We need new energy. We need new workers. That's what's going to keep this country prosperous. So we've got to have a strong legal immigration system. And once you build that, then you put pressure. Anyone who's in here illegally, you go home. You've got to come through the system legally. And if you have no legal outlet, we'll never be able to fix the legal immigration system. You've got to, the illegal immigration, you've got to do both simultaneously. So I think it's a critical issue. It's one that I'm disappointed that we haven't already started really addressing in this Congress. And it's something that you always hear folks talk about, but they never get really in there. And I think the solutions are pretty black and white. There's not a million solutions on the table. And you just need the courage.
Lock it down.
Enforce the law. It's a rule of law issue. You know, how can we argue that we have a country that's a nation of laws when we don't respect our own laws? Such a warm place to be in Bonner Springs. I hope to come back soon.
Well, we're going to try to get you back.
All right. Thanks. Thank you, everybody. Have a good evening.